her part of this organisation that's joined together today and address both legal issues of how to manage this land in this country. Could you? Who has been instrumental in helping us to conduct the business of the Māori government. The Māori government, as far as we are concerned, in the structure of spirituality, of legislature, is the administrator within the structure. So, where the decisions are centred to, in the part of the arena, and are legislated within the Wakamina or the Confederation of Chiefs, the Māori government is obliged to carry those decisions. But also, thank you, John, for asking me to stand. I want to acknowledge Sina Kura, Ariki Nui, Kapaini, Ngā Kāwai Nāna. Your position for the last 20 years has been the Prime Minister of the Māori government. So I acknowledge all of you that she has done. And my feet cannot fit in her shoes. And I honour her for this moment. So, we are here today to be part of these proceedings, to participate in the board today.
Okay, I just want to go back and go to And you were there, Danny, okay? It was just around the corner, the bar around the corner. And that was when our Warren Kings was still living. Dalia Hoon had passed away, Mumu Manuko had passed away, but we had much of Tara was still alive, okay? And today is that this is the first time we've actually carried this through from, I think was it, I'm not sure, John, was it 2009 or 2010? Because you had put it up on Facebook.
2009 would have been the Lisbon Treaty.
Yeah.
And from that point on, the policy.
Yeah. So this is the first time we've carried it, and I'd like to, you know, thanks to Edwinie and Bundy for you know, we've been asking Arikis up north, and so, you know, like, I pay my respect and thanks very much to Manahi, Bundy and Hiruini and Wiriru and all the others who decided, well, we're not going to wait for everybody, we're going to do something, you know, and if it wasn't for you guys, the Wakamini Confederation of Chiefs, we'll be going under. Our waka would be just like you know, lockdown, dry dock, lockdown. But thank you for you know, showing the initiative that we've got to do something, we've got to move. And tautoko what John Wainua is doing, you know. So it's about this kaupapa that you're taking us to the next step, John Wainua, and you know, on behalf of the Wakamini Confederation of Chiefs, where I was appointed by Mohu Manuko and Dao Wehimi, who have passed away, and we just thank this our arikis here that wasn't for them, and the initiative of Edward, that you've been able to pull them all up north. Thank you very much, you know, because the thing is that what's the point of having a government administrator if we're not going to be paid for it? You know, it's been a long time, 8 years. And thank you very much for your initiative to that, you know. Okay. That's all I have to say. I just, you know, so this is the co-copper. Kia ora. Connected to the
half of our funding comes from there and here in Manahi. Manahi is from Rangitupia, and we are connected to each other with the Parapas and the Mohinis, and one was there for a long time. But we connect the Mohinis there to the father, because on my mother's side, Kaikai, in contract with the king, and it's unbroken until we go to Eden to change the partnership of Adam. This site has still got its contract to the Newfoundland company, New South Wales, Australia, to deal with. So the Maori government has to fashion itself into today's world on this side. They don't really care because this keep reading are using this flag for themselves and their own. It's a private contract, nobody is doing this. So we are private commercial landowners on this planet and not, in a Hariki sense, has nothing to do with commercial trading and banks and money and all of that sort of thing. We need to have this to play the game. And there are the very highest things. We have the most powerful memorials to land in the world. King William's flag, his memorial as a trading partner, two-party contract, through magistrate court, and we have the Maori statue standing in London, and standing in Dunedin, and standing in Auckland, then in Washington DC, New York, Brussels, France, London, Singapore, Chile. The most powerful countries in the world are holding our Maori as a commercial entity. They're using our spirit of God's law, L-O-R-E, truth, deeds of truth, to smother everyone else, because if it's a pirate's flag given to us to ward off pirates. That's the black slippers. It's there because it's a protectorate from the Navy, Royal British Navy, and military. In times like this, we can call on. We are calling on the British military to fix the problem in Wellington, because they have run off with this title from the King's Bench Court as a Queen's Bench Court administrator of King's Bench Court's Royal Wellington, prize possessions, and leasehold, and everything else that's been accumulated from his title belong to the Paramount Chiefs. So I'm putting the Paramount Chiefs in place to administer the land here, Bungie, as an overarching title to the country. The Maori government talks to him because he spoke to Britain on this two-party contract, and this is a third party. The Maori government will fix up the third party and transition back into the safety of the King's Bench Court with no debt, no mortgages, no nothing on this side. That's what we're doing with this court case today, is take the mortgage off the land and put it back into customer control. We don't need mortgages. So that's the point of what I'm saying today. I'm getting the land commission, involved as administrative director. You need a government, of course. It'll take a while for them to catch up to speed, because we have an overarching Maori Crown, that's the Maori standard, depending on Maori Crown, federal state government of the world. This is covering the whole world where they took this flag and went down it. And so, I guess, we're preventing. It's not up to them to make that call. We make the call, we make them accountable, and get King Tākehi's talents to use as instruments against any complaint against this crown, New Zealand's crown, straight to the British crown, and the Maori crown standing in London and standing in Auckland. They can't hear it in the museum. And the one in Dunedin has his crown on his head. They put it there, the crown, Queen Victoria, and Queen Elizabeth, put it there because of the crown on his head. The other countries, they popped off. Even in Britain, they took the crown off and assumed they had the crown. I'm talking about God's crown, to God's earth, his mother. So that's a very powerful memorial to the land of Ahun Whenua, where he's based, he's Ahun, and he's there in Whenua underneath. So all we have to do is stand beside him, stand beside the king and the flag over there, and we're in business, as it should have been long ago. But it's taken a long time to get it across to our people, but they will eventually get it and get up to speed, because we're going straight into the mainstream after this with confidence. These men have got confidence, especially Philemon. He is the first of the settlers here that have settled himself, but he's got a bone to pick with his ancestors in England. He can go there, I think he'd like to be involved, but to go there and stand there and say, right, he didn't tell us what the deal was. And so we're calling the shots of the deal of where you're going to get. And so that's all I need to say about that and myself. Why are you going there to live as an ambassador for all countries, perfect country with a thing? I'm saying it was a perfect country. It's up to them to say it. And I'm saying today, it's 970 million trillion pounds, that's one single pound of money, love it. And they're going to force it today. And it's up to them to tell me it's not that bad, it's this bad. So we are assessing the damage in one lock, stock, barrel, native, right to the world, because they use this blueprint as their precedent case, right to the world, for the Queen, our people, and their title, that they fashioned out the New Zealand Crown, government of London, they fashioned that land title. You can carry on being Māori, but take the Māori away from them, and you'll find that they are the ones that are taking away from themselves. Now the latest is Judith Collins has, with her Chinese husband, dug up the Kauri Lock up north before Marsden Point, and that's where the fuel line split. They're not too bothered about fuel driving away and spilling out. They're not bothered about that. They want the money from the lots. They've got 1 million each coming along that the solar for the Chinese. We've got a bunch of people that the Montana coming from of the land there. These are some of the claims up the books. That's just the first one, right through the world. I'll make this statement. Can't cite it. Evidence on these videos. So that's what gave me the case in Auckland that they wouldn't let me in court. I've never had my hand in court. This is my hand in court because the system, the justice system, won't work for me in barring me from going to court. And so we'll put this case straight into the Westminster Magistrate Court in Westminster City, outside of the London City, Westminster, in the Trafalgar Square, that's where the Admiralty building is, where all this history will go in, all these will go in with our native here to put on the story. All the stuff I've got in the books, and it will go to the library in Auckland, when it gets out, and you're quite welcome to go into the library and help us out. Some of it is going online, but a lot of that they won't understand. It's past their time of birth. 1824, cut off that date. Only to 1840. That's the period that concerns us. If you forget all the other kings and queens, because all of the king's titles were consolidated into the New York Stock Exchange. And that's where our birth certificate was in 1831 in St. Mary's Church of Kitty. That set the precedent case for that site. And you'll see on Mount Indian Hill in 1923 on the part of the trick, the survey mark, that's when North America had become better. You see, all those end up to these skinny parts in this way, and we're going to fit that side of making them accountable for taking resources and especially injury or damage in people. So I'm including all the people in the world as well. In the Maori Crown sense, we are all one people as being claimants in what we claim on one people to hold. Now I'm just saying this today. If we get one people in, it's the same people in that the world of previous times. The king is to set it up. And these folks will be running it until it switches. I won't go through that. But I'm just saying to explain it to you clearly and people watching. The many videos I put out, much better ones, I think it was bad ones by out there people. It really makes me annoyed when I'm trying to say something that's way beyond out of it. But eventually, they are say, oh, I've got to give it all back, and this is the only way I can think about food. So I think I've said enough, and we'll move on into the court case. I just want to, rather than ask Christian, we'll leave that for after, because the sooner we get these books, we're taking one to the police station, come on notice. We're taking one down to the Auckland District Court, come on notice, the registrar. And we're taking one to the lawyer, and we set up this case in 2012, straight into the High Court of Basilea in London, and John Keating and signed it here. He's liable to it. I'm talking about Yoon Tai Choi in South Korea. He works for another law firm that does for Super Island commercial trading. And so he wants to be involved, so he will have to pick up on that and carry on. But that's, I'm saying, these are legal and they're already in trouble. You can't go back on this. You can inform you that this belongs to you. And every other person in this country has the same thing. Owners, administrators,